Hello and welcome to ITC Tech Share. I'm Tom Grissom. Today I'd like to share some of the trials and tribulations we have with a Miracast wireless display technology that we're currently testing out here in the ITC. To begin with, one of the challenges as teachers, we're always wanting to show whatever's on our screen up to a big screen. So in this case, I have an HDTV. The traditional way would be to get an adapter. And since I'm using the Surface Pro here, it requires a display port to a VGA connector. And then I have a VGA connector that is connected into the back of the TV. So it's just a matter of getting the correct adapter for whatever device you're using. And then in this case, I'm going to plug it into the mini display port and then give it just a second to recognize, and I have my screen. So you can see whatever's up on my screen, you'll be able to see up on the big screen. Okay, so that's the traditional way. We've been doing that for a couple of decades plus now. But wouldn't it be nice if we would be able to come out and do this all wirelessly? Well, that's what Miracast will do. To begin with, let me disconnect this. Let me tell you a little bit about the setup here first. To begin with, we have an HDTV. This is an older Sharp TV. It's about 5 years old, and it's got a VGA connector in the back, and then it also has four different HDMI connectors. Now, in order to connect something wireless, we have to have a receiver. So there are a number of boxes out on the market, and the first one I'll talk about is this Netgear box, just a small little black box. It has an HDMI connector that goes from the receiver into the back HDMI port. So let me just switch over here. Let's switch the input on this TV to input number 7. That is what I have the Netgear connected to. And you'll see here when it switches, we're currently in settings mode here on the Netgear. Because this is a nascent technology, you need to make sure that you have your firmware up to date. So this is version 2.4.3, the most recent. I've also have all the updates and firmware on the Surface Pro. However, we're still having difficulty connecting with the Netgear device. This is the PTV3000. So I need to get into connect mode. So to do that, I'm going to have to unplug this and plug it back in, and that will cause this to do a reboot. So this little device going to reboot. It'll take about 20 or 30 seconds for it to do that. So once it gets into connect mode, then I can pair my screen to the HDTV. Now, to show that I don't have anything connected, let me just disconnect my VGA cable. I no longer need this because we're going to make a wireless connection. Okay, and we can see here it's back up. It's going through its last check, and then it should come up and say ready to connect. Let me lay the VGA cable down here, back to the side. So it says ready for connection. Now we are also testing out, if I go out here to input number 8, we are also testing out the screen beam program. And I've had this one working for well over 10 months now, started back in January, February. This has been a very reliable device. Some of the updates with Windows 8.1 is causing some problems with the Netgear device. So we're still working through some of those issues. So I just switched my HDTV. Again, it's just a similar little black box here. This is the ActionTech screen beam. HDMI cable going back to input number 8, and then also I have a power adapter here. So the screen beam product is also ready to connect mode. So how do I connect a tablet, a Windows 8.1 tablet or device, to the screen wirelessly? Well, to begin with, I'm going to swipe in, get my charms menu, and I'm going to choose device, and I'm going to choose project. All right, if I've already previously connected, I should see my device in this list. Since I've removed all of those, I'm going to select add a wireless display. It will go through and scan, and it's already found the screen beam device. It takes about 30 seconds once again to do a scan, and it's still looking for the Netgear device. So we're still having some technical difficulties with that, and it's very intermittent. I haven't consistently gotten it to work. But since screen beam is already here, and since we're on this channel here, it pops up. The first time that you connect to it, it's going to offer a security code. So I'm going to punch this number in on the screen. And you have about 60 seconds to do this. And then click next. And if I entered the code correctly, it will go out, verify the security code, and it'll make the connection. And now then we should be wireless here. It says successfully paired with the screen beam. And then we're just waiting for that final pairing. And it should be any second. There we go. So now then, I have my screen beam program. So now I am completely wireless. Let me get rid of the keyboard. I don't need that. This is the Surface Pro tablet. So we're operating completely wireless, and this has kind of been the teacher's dream to be able to roam about the room, hand the tablet off to the student, let the student do the work, see everything up on the big screen so the class can see what's going on. If I want to jump over to the desktop, here's my desktop tile, just to show you some of the things with Windows 8. Let's just go over here and open up a finance app. So we are completely wireless, and we're using the screen beam to connect wirelessly now using a technology called Miracast. So let's just go back here and put this up. Now, a couple of tips. I ran into a couple of problems. One of the problems I had was when I originally connected this in Windows 8.1, I had sound coming out my device, but the sound did not come through the HDTV speakers. So to check that, I'm going to go over here to search. And let's just do a search for sound. And I need to go to my sound settings. And you want to make sure, and this did not happen the first time I paired this up, but it's remembered the settings since. Originally, it was on speaker. So the sound was coming out my Surface Pro, but not the HDTV. If you want the sound to also come out where the video is showing on the HDTV, make sure you set as default speakers/Intel WiDi. So that's one little tip out there. The other tip, let me go down here to settings. Let's go to change display and go to our devices tab. Right now you can see that I have the screen beam underneath my projectors. I should also be seeing the Netgear. So I'm going to go up here and select add a device again. My Netgear is out there on input number 7, so you can see that it's sitting out there in ready to connect mode. The Surface Pro is out there scanning, trying to find it, but it never registers. So there's still some troubleshooting to do there. I've had this working in the past. I've had it working well in Windows 8, but something between the firmware on the Netgear and the Windows 8.1 update is still causing some conflicts. But the screen beam program is working very well for me with 8.1. So let's go over here to input number 8, go back to our screen beam, and we'll see, it should pop up here in just a second. It says ready to connect. So let me come out here, and let's go to devices, project, and then it's scanning, select screen beam. It's scanning, verifying the security code. I already punched that code in, so it doesn't have to go back and re-enter. We don't have to go back and re-enter the code. And here's my desktop. Here is my start screen. So all completely wireless.